Dear viewers, Drishti IAS welcomes you to the new series of Simplified. Today's topic of discussion is 20th century major events and movements. The dimensions we are going to cover are major movements during pre-Gandhian era, major movements during Gandhian era, and revolutionary activities. So let's begin with major movements during pre-Gandhian era. First is Swadeshi movement. The cause of this movement was against the partition of Bengal. Announcement of this movement was made on August 7, 1905. Partition of Bengal on October 16, 1905. The day of partition was observed as day of mourning. Main leaders of this movement were Calcutta, Surendranath Banerjee and Anand Mohan Bose. Pune and Bombay, Bal Gangadhar Tilak. Punjab, Lala Lajpat Rai and Ajit Singh. Delhi, Sayyid Haider Raza and Madras, Chidambaram Pillai. Major activities during Swadeshi movement were boycott of foreign goods, public meetings and protests, formation of voluntary organizations and committees, national education program, promotion of indigenous industries, etc. Active participation of students, women, Muslim leaders, and lower middle class living in cities and towns. Differences between moderates and extremists regarding the Swadeshi movement and other issues. The split of the Congress in the Surat session of 1907. The partition of Bengal was annulled in 1911. Next one is Home Rule League movement. Objective of this movement was All India Home Rule or Self-Government under the British Commonwealth. It marked the beginning of two home rules. First was Tilak's Home Rule League. This league was established in April 1916. Headquarter was in Pune and the area was Maharashtra and Karnataka. Second home rule was Annie Besant's Home Rule League, which was established in September 1916 and branches were almost all over India. Prominent personalities of this movement were Motilal Nehru, Jawaharlal Nehru, Bhulabhai Desai, Chittaranjan Das, Madan Mohan Malviya, Muhammad Ali Jinnah, Tej Bahadur Sapru and Lala Lajpat Rai. Mahatma Gandhi was not its member but presided over it in 1920. Its name was changed to Swarajya Sabha in Bombay in October 1920. Achievements of this movement were, it propounded the importance of the general public rather than only the educated class. It formed the basis of the Gandhian phase, agreement between extremists and moderates in Congress. Now moving on to the next dimension, that is major movements during Gandhian era. First one is Champaran Satyagraha. It started in 1917 in Champaran, Bihar. Main cause was Tinkathia system, that is, under this system, farmers were required to cultivate indigo on 3/20th of their land. Other prominent personalities were Rajkumar Shukla, Rajendra Prasad, Mahadev Desai, Narhari Parikh and J.B. Kripalani. Rabindranath Tagore gave the title of Mahatma to Mohandas Karamchand Gandhi. Next is Ahmedabad Mill Strike. The time of this strike was 1918 and the cause was dispute between mill owners and workers over plague bonus. Other prominent leader was Anusuya Ben Sarabhai. Mahatma Gandhi's first hunger strike on the land of India. Now moving on to the Kheda Satyagraha. It started in 1918 and the main cause was, despite crop failure in Kheda, revenue was collected by the government. Important leaders were Vallabhbhai Patel and Indulal Yagnik. Now next is Satyagraha against the Rowlatt Act. It started in 1919. It was based on No Daleel, No Vakil, No Appeal. That is, no pleas, no lawyer, no appeal. Mahatma Gandhi called for a nationwide movement in protest against this. Next is Jallianwala Bagh Massacre. On the day of Vaisakhi on 13 April 1919, General Dyer ordered to open fire at Jallianwala Bagh in Amritsar. The meeting was organized in protest against the arrest of Dr. Satyapal and Saifuddin Kichlu. In protest against this massacre, Rabindranath Tagore renounced the title of knighthood and Mahatma Gandhi renounced the title of Kesare Hind. Sankaran Nair resigned as member of the Viceroy's executive. Congress formed a non-official committee that included Motilal Nehru, C.R. Das, M.R. Jayakar and Gandhiji to investigate the massacre. The government constituted the Hunter Commission that included three Indians, Chimanlal Sitalwad, Sultan Ahmed and Jagat Narayan. Now next is Khilafat Movement. This movement started with the formation of Khilafat Committee in 1919 under the leadership of Ali brothers, that is Muhammad Ali and Shaukat Ali. Mahatma Gandhi presided over the meeting of the Khilafat Committee held in Delhi. This movement ended in 1924 when Kamal Pasha abolished the post of Caliph after forming the government in Turkey. Next is Non-Cooperation Movement. It was started on 1 August 1920. Lokmanya Tilak died on the day the movement started. On 5 February 1922, a police station was set on fire at Chauri Chaura in Gorakhpur district of the United Provinces. The non-cooperation movement was withdrawn on 12 February 1922 after the Chauri Chaura incident. Now next comes the civil disobedience movement. Mahatma Gandhi reached Dandi on 5 April 1930 from Sabarmati Ashram under the civil disobedience movement, which was called Dandi March. On 6 April 1930, salt law was broken by making salt in Dandi. Subhash Chandra Bose compared this campaign with Napoleon's Paris March and Mussolini's Rome March. The aim of this movement was a complete disobedience of the orders of the British government. During this movement, it was decided that India would celebrate 26th January as Independence Day all over the country. On 26th January 1930, meetings were held all over the country and the Congress tricolor was hoisted. Next is Dilli Chalo movement or Individual Satyagraha. It was started against the August proposal. It started in 1940 in Pavnar Ashram, Maharashtra. First Satyagrahi was Vinoba Bhave and second Satyagrahi was Jawaharlal Nehru. Next is Quit India Movement, that is August Revolution. It started in August 1942. The main centers of this movement were Bengal, Bihar, United Provinces, Karnataka and Bombay. Congress passed it in the Wardha session on 14 July 1942. This proposal was approved in the meeting of the Congress Committee held at Gwalior Tank in Bombay on 8 August 1942. On 9 August 1942, Mahatma Gandhi and other prominent leaders were arrested under Operation Zero R. Now let's see revolutionary activities. First of all, activities before the First World War. Activity in Bengal. 1902, Anushilan Samiti, establishment of the first revolutionary organization in Midnapur and Calcutta. 1908, Khudiram Bose and Prafulla Chaki attempted to assassinate Judge King's fort of Muzaffarpur district, Bihar. Arvind Ghosh and Barindra Kumar Ghosh accused of Alipur conspiracy case. 1912 Delhi conspiracy case, in which the mastermind was Raj Bihari Bose, who attempted to assassinate Lord Harding, the then Viceroy of India. Bomb was thrown on the convoy of Lord Harding. Now the activities in Maharashtra. 1897, the Chapekar brothers killed Rand, chairman of Pune Plague Committee, and the Lieutenant Ayrust, establishment of Mitra Mela by Savarkar, and 1904, merger of Mitra Mela with Abhinav Bharat. Now moving on to some other activities. 1905, establishment of India House, India Home Rule Society in London by Shyamji Krishna Verma. 1909, assassination of William Curzon Wiley by Madan Lal Dhingra. 1913, Gadar Party was founded in San Francisco, USA. 1914, the Kamagata Maru incident. Now lastly, the activities after the First World War. 9 August 1925, Kakori Conspiracy. 1928, assassination of Saunders. 8 April 1929, bombs were thrown in the Central Legislative Assembly by Bhagat Singh and Batukeshwar Dutt. 23 March 1931, Bhagat Singh, Rajguru and Sukhdev were hanged in Lahore jail. And lastly, 1930, Chittagong Armory Raid that was led by Surya Sen. So that's all for today. Stay tuned for the next episode. Thanks for watching.